I am happy to introduce our two performers for the day, Claire Simard and Walter Kramer. And if you look at your programs, you can see that Claire has had extensive training, background training in musical, opera, here and in Europe, and she has performed nearby in Richfield, and she is part of the faculty at Worcester School. And Walt Kramer is the Dean of Students at WestCon, and he also has had extensive training, if you look in your program in musical theater and opera, in a variety of places in different parts of the country. And I saw Walt and Claire in Annie last summer here, musicals at Richter. It was fantastic. So now I would like to introduce Claire and Walt.
This is my second time here. I was here about 2 years ago and had such a great time, did British and American art songs, called it Across the Pond. I had such a good time, thought I'd come back. And the association nicely invited me back. And I was so impressed. Judy mentioned that this summer Claire and I did Annie. I played Daddy Warbucks.
And I played Annie.
Yes. That would have been almost.
What?
And Claire was Grace, my loyal secretary.
Yes.
And so some people wondered what happened to Daddy Warbucks and Grace, because at the end of the show, despite our age difference, we kind of walked off in the sunset hand in hand. And we've been on tour around the United States doing concerts just like this. So that's a lie. That's a lie. But it is fun to be together. And just a quick note, we actually did have an accompanist.
We did.
About 3 weeks ago.
I learned how to play piano in 3 weeks.
That's right. We lost the accompanist who had something else came up. And Claire and I didn't panic quite, but no. we made a few phone calls, and everybody was busy. And Claire said to me, "I've got an idea." And I thought, Andy Rooney, Judy Garland, okay, what's this going to be? And Claire said, "I'll play." And so we got together, and as you can see, other than page-turning talent, she's a hell of a musician and an incredible. And I'm useless as I'm a tenor, so I'm useless as a page turner. So, did I forget anything about how we got here?
No, just the last time you were here, it was kind of funny. All of the chairs in this room were turned this way. It was August 12th.
That's right.
August 12th. It was the last night of Annie. After a three-week run outside the beautiful musicals at Richter. And our last night was like 100,000% forecast of rain. And we were all like heartbroken. Because of course when it rains you can't do outdoor theater. Yes, so our director said, well, we're going to do the show anyway and we will fit as many people as we possibly can in here. We'll do the show here. This was the stage and the orchestra was in the hallway, the vestibule.
It really was.
Yeah, and it was amazing doing that whole show so close. I mean, a show that's so big. It's so big. It's such a big show. And it was really fun. It was kind of like doing it in Daddy Warbucks' doing Annie in Daddy Warbucks' mansion. Like, kind of.
Yeah, that's, kind I think of. His was bigger.
Yeah, I think so. But it was fun. It was
anyway, fun. That's how we got here. Anyone can whistle. That's what they say, easy. Anyone can whistle any whole day, easy. It's all so simple. Relax, let go, let fly. So someone tell me why. Thank you.
slay a dragon any old week. Easy.
My dad would take me out and we would go, you know, feed the ducks, feed the swans. So a little four-year-old Claire's like walking down Cabred, you know, walking out to the dock and with my dad, and we're feeding them. Oh, wow, there's a little family of swans. Oh, there's the mom and there's the dad. Oh, I don't have any more bread, Dad. Ah, I mean, in my face. Swans attacking feathers, wings. And when you're a four-year-old child, swans, multiple with their beaks. It was like a scene out of The Birds. Needless to say, I was traumatized. And ever since that day, I've had a deathly fear of birds. Living or dead, I seem to run into them. You know, they seem to, I attract them. You know, you kind of attract what you think about. I'm like, oh, I hope I don't see a dead bird. I'm walking down the street and there's one I step on it. So this next song is, it's called Karma.
Complete for me, that makes every Sunday
my funny Valentine, sweet comic Valentine. You make me smile with my heart. Your looks are laughable, fun photographable, yet you're my favorite work of art. Is your figure less than
Thank you.
I didn't even write the blah blah part. Next, we've got a song by another one of my favorite composers, Stephen Schwartz, who lives right in Ridgefield. And also, fun fact for Worcester folks who are here, his son is a Worcester alum. I know. This is a song that is not often sung from a musical that is never done, called The Baker's Wife. Great, I'm setting it up great. This is such a beautiful song, and I love it because, well, I first heard it done by Stephen Schwartz at a gala performance a couple of years ago, and I was like, ooh, I love this song because it's in French, and then it's not in French, and it's just such a beautiful story, and I love everything French. So this is Chanson.
Il voyage, le monde fait un tour.
do a concert version of that at least,
yeah.
and have Claire play that role. Just saying, for anybody who's in the room that produces and directs musicals, I think they're that's gorgeous.
Just once in my lifetime, a man knows a moment, one wonderful moment when fate takes his hand, and this is my moment, my once in a lifetime, when I can explore a new and exciting land. For once in my lifetime, I feel like a giant. I soar like an eagle, as though I had wings. And this is my moment, my destiny calls me. Just once in my life's time, I'm gonna do great things. My lifetime, I
us now and Guys and Dolls. We kind of reversed the roles because I really liked the transition from Once in a Lifetime. That key was like the same key. It was really cool. And I've had this affinity for male roles that I will never play. Tevye, Mushnick in Little Shop, I would be a great Mushnick. Sky might be a great Sky Masterson, but nobody, until actually this fall, they did a company, a production of Company, Stephen Sondheim's Company, in London, where they reversed it and Bobby, B-O-B-B-I, was played by a woman. How cool is that? And so they're like, doo-doo, doo-doo. I don't know if any of you are musical theater fans, but I think it's cool. And so she sang Being Alive and all of the great songs that Bobby sang, and the song that You Could Drive a Person Crazy, which is normally sung by three women, is sung by her three boyfriends. And it's really, really fun. It's a great cast recording if you get a chance to listen to it. And Patti LuPone sings The Ladies from Lunch. And that just in itself is worth listening to.
Speaking of roles one will never play, for those of you who don't know 1776, this next song, Mama Look Sharp, is one of my favorite. I'm a 16, 17, 18 year old courier out on the battlefield in the Revolutionary War. Imagine my mother singing about. And actually, in more or less, I think it's the soldier thinking that his mother's singing, then she's actually singing. It's one of my most favorite. God, my mother was an English teacher. I should talk better. It's one of my favorite songs, and I'm dedicating this, if she ever watches this video, to my dear friend Candy Harrison. When I was at Indiana University, she just fell in love with this song, and she's always encouraged me to sing it. I've never had a chance to. So I'm finally getting to do it all these years later.
Thank you.
public. This was given to me in 2002, by the man who played Mushnik in A Little Shop of Horrors. I was doing summer theater at the Struthers Library Theater in Struthers, Pennsylvania. And he said, I love this song, you should sing it. And I've never been able to sing it until now, because I can never get through it. Yay!
Okay. So, I'm going to say something.
That's great.
Take a break.
Does
anybody know that song before?
No.
I didn't either. You know, the truth is, I'm so glad the accompanist kind of went elsewhere, because she's terrific, isn't she? I mean, not only is she beautiful, I love her playing. I mean, and accompanying me in the little interludes, it's just, I sometimes get lost as she's playing. So thank you for doing this. Just, it's been a treat to hear you sing and perform with you.
I've never done this.
It ain't easy, I'm sure.
Before, so. But I do this all the time. This is why I suggested this, because this is literally what I do at home all the time. And I'll be like, well, it'll just be like in my living room, but bigger.
Yeah.
No, yeah. I love to play and sing, so I thought it would give me more freedom actually, to really be like inside the music, because I'm in control.
I think it worked, didn't it?
I'm fine. Okay. Totally fine.
Let me die.
playing. This has been such a treat for me to be able to work on all this music and to sing with you. It's just been so wonderful, Walt, because you just, singing just exudes from you, and it's just so much fun. We've had so much fun getting ready for this concert. We started talking about music months and months and months ago. And this is a song from The Bridges of Madison County, which is a 2014 musical, a kind of brief run on Broadway, unfortunately. Jason Robert Brown, who, oh gosh, he hasn't, I don't know if he's written any like commercial hits, but like Songs for a New World, and he wrote the musical 13, which, I don't know. Anyway, he wrote this show. It's fantastically beautiful music, and it's based off of the book, which also inspired the movie with Meryl Streep and Clint Eastwood. Long story short, a photographer is on assignment to shoot the famous bridges in Madison County, Iowa, and he meets this housewife who her family has left to go to a, like, 4-H fair for the weekend. They fall in love and have this really like intense 24-hour relationship where everything changes for her, and he wants her to leave with him. Her family comes home, and she has to make a decision. And my favorite line in this is that what I did is that we loved, and love is always better.
Thank you.
should bow. Time for our finale?
Absolutely.
Thank you. I think we've run over a little bit. What time?
Cheers.
Thank you. Oh, you're so kind. So, thank you all. Thank you all for coming. It has been a pleasure for us. May I speak on your behalf? It's been a pleasure for us. I've just had a great time getting to know Claire's music better. If she's ever in a show, you got to come see it. Just amazing. And speaking of shows, those very people I was teasing about doing a concert version of The Baker's Wife are going to be doing a little ditty of a show here called Spamalot. Anybody know? Yeah. This summer, I can say that, can I, Joyce?
Yeah.
Okay. I thought I saw it announced. Yeah. And so we thought, just for a little something different. A role that you could play, but I'm...
Arthur? I only want to play male roles.
Am I Sir Robin? I forget. Is that this?
This is Dennis.
This is Dennis. This is Dennis Galahad. Of course it is. Silly me.
So Dennis.
So you have to think of me as a knight of the round table. There comes a song like this. It starts off soft and low and ends up with a kiss. What is that song that goes it like this? Where is it? My destiny calls me.